workers, right? Have any of y'all heard of the Sentosa 27?
Yeah!
The Sentosa Merchants. All right, because we're going to get a little bit of an update. If you haven't, that's all right. Terry from NAFCON is going to give us an update right now on the state of all of these Filipino workers talking on the Sentosa 27.
Yeah!
All right. Thank you, Kane. So I'm here to talk a little bit about the Sentosa nurses, but all of the situation of our Filipino Kababayans who are here in the United States and overseas because they couldn't find a living in the Philippines. They're scaring me, right? So the conditions in the Philippines, Reverend Larry Emery talked about the political and military situation there. We also know the economic situation there drives thousands of people out of the Philippines every day. More than 3,000 Filipinos leave the Philippines every day because they cannot find a living in the Philippines. I'm with the NAFCON, the National Alliance for Filipino Concerns, here in Northern California. It's a national alliance in over 23 cities across the country, and we're trying to deal with the issues of rights and welfare of our Kababayans here in the United States. Now, this struggle and the struggle we're facing and the struggle we're fighting for with our organizations is a continuation of the struggle of the farm workers, right? The continuation of the struggle of the World War II veterans. The airport screeners issue that initiated a lot of our organizing here in the Bay Area, or actually enhanced a lot of our organizing here. 6 years later, we're only seeing partial justice for the more than 1,000 Filipino airport screeners. A lot of you heard about the Custodio family. Some of us went down to San Jose yesterday. The Custodio family will face police brutality for no reason other than being Filipino in the United States, the same as the farm workers back in the day. And the Sentosa nurses, this issue is one that happened, you know, in New York, but two of the Sentosa nurses live here in the Bay Area, and we want to carry that struggle forward with them. Ed and Eileen, who couldn't be here today, have shared with us their story of being recruited in the Philippines by the Sentosa Recruitment Agency to work for nursing agencies here in the United States. They were exploited. Their passports were taken away. They weren't paid overtime. They were crammed into crowded living conditions with more than 10 other nurses in one apartment. They were made to take care of more than 60 mentally ill patients with just one nurse. These conditions are not what they signed up for when they were in the Philippines. So that kind of recruitment, that kind of exploitation of our Kababayans, more and more of that is going to happen because of the conditions in the Philippines, because of the immigration laws in the United States, which are moving us away from family-based immigration towards more guest worker programs and contract-based employment. So all of these struggles are the struggle for us to continue today, to continue the struggle of Philip Veracruz, to continue the struggle of Carlos Bulacan, and to stand in solidarity with all of our Kababayans here in the United States and in more than 150 countries around the world. We're here today in solidarity with all of our communities. We're here to seek full justice for the farm workers, for the World War II veterans, for the airport screeners, for the custodial family, and for the Sentosa nurses. They're not fighting just for themselves, they're also fighting for any other nurse or overseas worker who is going to face the same exploitation. For any other family that will face police brutality. The custodial family, they're not just out there for themselves, they're out there for all of us and for all of our relatives. Today we say justice for all immigrants and for all migrant workers, and mabuhay.